Okay, hopefully this will be a short one. And I got it done. Took me a bit to freaking get all the wires tucked back in there. I gotta cut out some more because she's sticking out just a little bit. But this is it. I got the P90 in there. She's sitting really good. I got the... It would look a little different because normally this has a cover on it. So it just... I wanted to keep the cover out so that I'd have it be better for what I wanted to do. So I did that. In case you guys didn't see the last one, go see the last one. I said everything how I did this. The main thing was this part. And that wasn't part of it. This was a part of it. So I was able to get the... I already had a jack in there. It was just a matter of me getting a tone and a volume and then a toggle switch in there to switch between the pickups. And if you watched the video before this, please watch the video. I don't have to explain all of this over again. But I got everything going. The neck was giving me a bit of grief. So what I had to do was get some toothpicks and stick them into the neck and put the screws back in, because they were stripped and they were losing their bite. So it was going out of tune a lot. Like, I just put it down. I would put it down and she'd go out of tune. So I was like, ah, okay. That's not tuning machines or anything like that. I know what that is. So if your guitar goes out of tune a lot, check the tightness of the screws. If it's a set neck, you got issues. But if it's a bolt on, chances are the screws aren't tightened enough so that because the neck will give, right? So the neck will give because of the tension of the strings. So I guess the only other thing that we didn't cover in there was mentioning that Keith Richards used the twin. He would use twins. So and then he would also use a what pedal was that? The TS-8 or the TS-9 tube screamer. So we don't have a tube screamer, but we do have the a Fender Hot Rod Deluxe Deville, and I have my volume control on the freaking effects loop to turn it down and push the gain. So I got the gain pushed up. The volume is up at 5 and the master is a little over 3, which normally would be like really jarringly loud, but and the presence is up towards about 8. The bass is all the way down. The treble is up about 7 and the mids I have pushed at about 5. And so that seems to have a decent tune for me. And so when I kick it back on, the tone is really good. I think that is the P90. That's giving me the best so far. So right, so I'll get it eventually. I'll freaking, well, that's why I got it, so I can practice the darn things, right? So The guy did it, and I swear to God, I thought I was going to be able to get it, but I don't know what the hell he did, but the can you hear me knocking part, I can't freaking figure that shit out for nothing. I think that's about as close as I'm gonna get to his tone. I mean, seriously. What do you think? What are your thoughts? I'm digging it so much. I'm almost tempted to freaking eventually put this in a completely different guitar. Because it just sounds awesome. So and shit like that. So like I said, I was able to get the switch in the way I wanted it to get it in. The only thing that you know, as for this particular unit, the only thing is the problem that I'm having so far is freaking smacking the switch. So every time I put it down, I smack it. So outside of that, you know, it's just the way it is. It's working good. I'm loving it. Three position for this is the rhythm. Both. And then the P90. That's the P90, nice and bright. Middle. And then the neck. You, but I think it's cool. And that'll be it for me. Just wanted to show you what a little frickin' and tinkering around can do. And, but yeah, I think he was onto something with the goddamn setup like this. So, yeah, man, P90 in the frickin' bridge. Usually you see it the other way around, right? P90 in the neck and then the frickin' hum in the back. But, yeah, that's, I'm kind of digging on that. And to think that this is the P90 that came out of the Dean, the Palomino. This was the, not the middle one. This was the bridge. This is the bridge one, because I had moved one down. And the reason why I had done that is because when I was playing it on the Dean, for some reason, it was just, when I threw a little gain on there, she didn't like the gain at all. And for some reason, she really likes the gain on here. And it had the foam in the back of it and everything like that. But for some reason, it just wasn't, it wasn't happy. It really wasn't happy at all. And so it sounded shrill. Somebody said, once said, what did it sound like? Ice picks in the eyes. So I'm like, that sounds like it. So anyway, folks, that's it. I'll give you a little closer look. That's how I got it set up there. And so that works out really well for me so far. So I will spook with you. I got 12 minutes in, and I think I'm done. Peace, have a good one, and catch you all on the flip. Bitty, floppity, floop. Loop.